It was actually hard for me to, at first, be myself around him because I was so in awe of him. But his part of his genius was being able to bring someone out of themselves. He could tap into something very deep inside you and somehow just pull it out because you wanted to please him so much. For me, I wanted to please him so much and make him think I was so smart and cool and wonderful and all that I would just spill. And that's how he was with people. He could just elicit stunning results from people by being interested. And if he was interested, he was totally focused on you. We danced at first with the mothers, and one day he told us we should be a group and make a record. It was beyond my wildest dreams. I mean, I love bands, and I was already a groupie in quotes, and you know, the idea of being in a band and making a record was just with him too.
They were together as a group of people who just hung around together and had their own ingrown folklore and philosophy and theology, and you know, they were just seemed sort of a one mind type operation. And I thought it would be nice to give people in the outside world, that is outside the boundaries of Laurel Canyon, some idea of what was going on with these girls and show the way that they were thinking.
I can't sing, I'm just kidding. I see all the people I want to see. I be all the people I want to be. Along with the images I try to find. I forgot my lyrics.
All I want to see. I be all the people I want to be. And find all the treasures I want to find. Along with the images.
He, I think, saw us as a social commentary on the times, you know, and he wanted to capture that. That's another part of his brilliance. He'd like to put a frame around moments, you know, and startling moments and make them live forever. I think that's what he was doing with us.